Hi everyone, in this series we focus on the difference between written Persian and spoken Persian.
Spoken Persian, the language we use in our everyday interactions, is rather different from written Persian, which we use in formal writing, official news, and announcements. The difference is not that great though, and you will find it easy to understand and work with once you know its underlying principles. The first difference that we focus on is turning on into un. There's a very general tendency in Persian to turn on into un in everyday speech. You remember punzda and chunzda from the first episode of Persian number system. In written form, punzda is panzda and chunzda is shanzda. So you see that we turn on in the written version of the word to un when we actually speak. Similarly, we have asan in written Persian and asun in spoken Persian. Baran turns into barun, aseman to asemun, tabestan, tabestun, zemestan, zemestun, biaban, biabun, khiaban, khiabun, arzan, arzun, geran, gerun, jaban, jabun, nojaban, nojavun. Anja becomes unja, and anha becomes unha, and then it's further reduced to una. So the main principle is turning on into un. But there are a few exceptions to this principle. Number one, loan words. We don't turn on into un from written to spoken Persian if we have borrowed our word from a different language. For example, we took apartman and ascenseur originally from French, so we do not change them across register. Apartman and ascenseur keep the same pronunciation in both written and spoken Persian. And we took emtihan and alan from Arabic, so we wouldn't change the pronunciation of these two words in spoken Persian either. Similarly, avant-garde and parleman stay the same in both written and spoken Persian. And pelan, departman, randeman, kapitan, and maman do not change from written to spoken form. In addition to loan words, we also don't change the pronunciation of proper nouns like people or countries' names and official names of organizations and divisions. For example, Arman, a boy's name, stays the same in written and spoken Persian. And Arqavan, a girl's name, is always Arqavan, whether we're writing or saying it. Similarly, country names like Alman, Armenistan, and Yunnan stay the same in written and spoken Persian, although they have an in their final syllables. Official names for organizations and divisions like Dabestan, Dabirestan, Honarestan, Sazman, and Ostan also don't change their an into un in conversational Persian. But note that Iran and a number of its cities that end in an are sometimes used in the un form in everyday speech, although mostly by natives of Iran and those cities, to imply a sense of closeness and familiarity. So it's common to hear Iranians refer to Iran as Irun, and citizens of Isfahan, Behbahan, Tehran, Kashan, and Kerman to call their cities Isfahun, Behbahun, Tehrun, Kashun, and Kermun. Now let's put our knowledge into practice. First, tell me which word do you think changes in spoken Persian and how? None. None changes and turns into nun in spoken Persian. Bank. Bank doesn't change in spoken form because we took it from French. Arsalan. Arsalan also doesn't change because it's a boy name and a proper noun. Khane. Khane turns its an into un in everyday speech and becomes khune. Jan. Jan often turns into jun in conversational Persian. Restaurant. restaurant doesn't change its pronunciation because it's a loan word from French. Dandan. Dandan turns into dandun. Online. Online doesn't change because we took it from English. And ساختمان. ساختمان changes its final syllable from on into un in spoken form. And now turn the following sentences into spoken Persian. امروز آسمان آبی و صاف است. امروز آسمون آبی و صافه. You remember that the spoken form of است is a from our lesson on the difference between a, است and هست. دیروز بارانی بود. دیروز بارونی بود. ما مهمان داریم. ما مهمون داریم. خانه آنها وسط بیابان است. Here we have four changes. خونه اونا وسط بیابونه. تابستان آنجا گرم است. Here we have three changes. تابستون اونجا گرمه. And فارسی واقعا آسان است. فارسی واقعا آسونه.
Perfect. Now you know the first general difference between written and spoken Persian and how to use your knowledge like a native speaker. Have fun with your Persian and see you soon.